Thank you. Without objection, the previous question is ordered. The question is on adoption of the resolution. All those in favor say aye. All those opposed, no. In the opinion of the chair, the ayes have it, and the resolution is agreed to. Without objection, the motion to reconsider is laid upon the table. The chair now recognizes the delegate from the state of West Virginia for the purpose of offering a resolution.
Let's just explain to the viewers what exactly is going on right now. I want to bring in CNN's John King. John, explain what's going on. Who are the people yelling? What's happening?
Well, you have a protest on the floor. They had seemed to adopt the rules on a voice vote there, and the chairman said the ayes have it, trying to say the rules are adopted, and you have some delegates on the floor saying not so fast. And so we know the anti-Trump forces believe they submitted enough signatures to have that state-by-state roll call. The anti-Trump forces went to the Rules Committee, went to the leaders of the convention. They submitted what they say is enough signatures from enough states to have a state-by-state roll call, and I think we're going to have that litigated right now on the floor of the Republican convention.
So the people yelling right now, the people yelling aye are the Trump forces, and the people yelling nay are saying the rules should not be adopted. And the ayes, what are the nays trying to force? Roll call vote.
Right.
These are the never-Trump forces.
They want a roll call vote on the rules. This is their last gasp, if you will, avoiding their displeasure with Donald Trump and the displeasure with the Republican National Committee. They concede they don't have the votes in the end. They concede the Trump forces have more votes. But they want to say, and I know some of the people inside the Trump war room think they could have as many as 600 votes against the rules, meaning against Donald Trump. The last protest vote against Donald Trump, they're trying to send a signal. And again, I think Ed is right. I think they will be defeated in the end. I think the Trump forces have been working the floor. But there's a lot of resentment, Jake. I was on the floor for a little bit before I came up. Some of the Trump lieutenants were trying to convince people who signed the petitions to withdraw their signatures. And they're to pressure them to back off so that this doesn't happen, because they're trying to say we need party unity. We don't want to embarrass our nominee. But a lot of those delegates are taking, hey, this is my right to demand this. Don't pressure me.
Now, Ken Cuccinelli, the former attorney general of the Commonwealth of Virginia and a big Ted Cruz supporter, he just went up to the microphone. He put his credentials on the ground. Dana Bash, you're out on the floor following all the action. I don't know if you know what that meant. I don't know if you saw it happen. But who are these forces exactly? And explain what's going down from going on from the point of view of the floor.
Yeah, let me just, I'm not sure if you guys have explained this already. It's a little bit hard for me to hear because you can hear it's very, very loud. But the most important thing to know about what just happened from the chair, if you will, from the podium, is that they called the ayes have it and gavel. What does that mean? They just effectively tried to quash this whole movement to try to open up the rules package, basically to have effectively an open debate that will allow for amendments of all kinds on the floor of the convention. The picture of the man you're seeing
I want to listen to Senator Mike Lee. Senator Mike Lee, a Republican of Utah, who is a supporter of Ted Cruz. The delegates.
Why this makes sense. These are the very same people around the country who are going to need to be the engine for our nominee come in November and in the months leading up to November. So those who are calling for unity, need to keep that in mind. If what they want is unity, treat us respectfully as delegates.
Have they stopped it at this point?
Which one?
Have they stopped it?
Well, it's not clear what they've done. The podium has been abandoned. There is no one standing at the podium. There's absolutely nothing that has happened. So your guess is as good as mine.
That's Utah Senator Mike Lee. He is an ally of Ted Cruz. He is one of those individuals who believes that the delegates should be allowed to vote their conscience and not be bound by how their states voted. This is a movement. Some call it the Never Trump movement. Some call it the Unbind the Delegates movement. They are people who are trying to seek, in their view, a different and better candidate to challenge Hillary Clinton. Obviously, Donald Trump won the nomination in terms of delegates. These people are trying to change the rules so the delegates are unbound.